Falling Time. Straight-ahead action is a basic approach for animating a shot. Now, in straight-ahead action, you establish the first key pose and have an idea of what you want for the rest of the poses. Next, you draw the second key pose, then the third key, and so forth. Straight-ahead action is another one of the principles of animation, and it's commonly used in traditional and in stop-motion animation. There's another technique called pose-to-pose action that's more common for computer animation. For now, we'll start with straight-ahead action and see how it applies to falling motion. To animate a falling ball, you would start at the apex, which is key number one. To use straight-ahead action, we need to find the position of the ball for key number two, which is the first drawing after the apex. Of course, this position depends on the number of frames between key number one and key number two. Using basic physics, we can calculate the distance that an object falls after one frame, two frames, etc. This table lists the distance fallen from the apex after the first few frames. For example, after one frame, the distance fallen is a third of an inch, which is only slightly greater than the width of a pencil. After two frames, the distance fallen is 1 1/3 inches, which is about the width of two of my fingers. Now, your hand may be smaller or larger, so you may want to use another measure, such as the length of your thumb. Here are a few more values. After three frames, the distance fallen is 3 inches, which is the width of my fingers. After four frames, it's about the width of a CD. These images are an easy way for me to remember how far something falls in the first few frames. Now, you may want to come up with some of your own. Shooting on twos, the key drawing after the apex is located at about this position. Remember, after two frames, the ball falls a distance roughly equal to the width of two fingers. A convenient fact is that the distance that an object falls does not depend on its weight as long as the force of air resistance is minimal. This means that a baseball and a bowling ball fall together when released from the same apex. For very light objects like a ping pong ball, the motion is slower due to air resistance, and we'll discuss that in another video. Here's a larger table listing the distance fallen from the apex after a given number of frames. To calculate this table, or to find the distance for entries that are not in this table, you can use the following formula. Distance fallen in inches equals number of frames times number of frames times 1/3 of an inch. The table of distance fallen is also useful for planning a scene. For example, the table tells us that falling from a height of 4 feet takes 12 frames. Now, I should warn you that falling motion is often animated as being faster than reality, so use the table only as a guide, not an absolute rule. In planning a scene, you might also use a stopwatch to time the live action. This is called slugging a scene. Your reaction time is probably a quarter second delay, so should you subtract that much from the stopwatch reading? No, because there's a reaction time delay in hitting start, but also in hitting stop. These two delays roughly cancel each other out. If you're curious, you can measure your reaction time. Have a friend release a ruler and measure the distance that the ruler falls before you catch it. Typically, the ruler falls 8 to 12 inches before you react and catch it, which this table tells you is a reaction time between a fifth to a quarter seconds. In summary, in straight-ahead action, you start from the first key, then create the next key, etc. Everything falls with the same timing and spacing, if air resistance is negligible. After one frame, the distance fallen is about the width of a pencil. After two frames, it's about the width of two fingers. The distance fallen may be looked up in a table or calculated with a simple formula. The distance fallen table may also be used when planning the total length of a scene. And I should say that in the next few videos, we'll examine the rhythm of falling motion. This rhythm will allow you to create believable animated motion without having to make a lot of measurements. See you then.